This was one of my first 3D printed cases. Like I was telling you in the beginning, I did finish this project a few years ago. So let me show you the parts I've designed for this case. Everything is done in SketchUp. The case is built out of several separate parts. This is the main part. You can see the holes for the buttons on its top. The holes for the speakers on its sides, and we have this cutout here for the display. And since I'm printing it from this side up, this is how it's going to be sitting on the printer's bed. So I made another part, this one here, and it's going to be glued on the front of the case to give a clean look. It has a beveled outline, some 3D printed text, and also I beveled the holes for the screws so the screws will countersink. I thought it looks better like this. The back side of the case has a profile which will fit exactly on the main part, and it's held in place by four screws. I have the snooze button here, I mean the cover for the snooze button, which is also made out of two parts. And I also 3D modeled a cap for the volume potentiometer. You don't have to use this if you don't need it. And lastly, these parts here will be used to hold the speakers in place, and also this piece of fabric here, which covers the speakers and gives a nice finishing touch. Of course, you can go ahead and design your own case for this project, but if you like this, you'll find the STL files along with everything else, because it's all open source, like I promised in the beginning. So I'm going to turn on my 3D printer and print all these parts, and then we're going to put everything together into a finished product. So after printing all the parts for the case, you can go ahead and start the assembly process. And you can see here I've printed a second case for the alarm clock, just to be able to show you how it all looks and to give you some pointers with the assembly process. Whenever I finish printing something, I always clean the part, do some sanding if necessary, clean the edges, removing all the excess material. If you want to paint this, you can go ahead and do so. It's all finishing touches that you're doing at this point, because once you're starting the assembly process, it's going to be so much harder to do all these fine operations. Putting everything together is going to be pretty straightforward. You want to start by gluing this front cover on the main part. You got to make sure to have good alignment between these two parts and apply some pressure and just let it a few minutes. The next step is to mount the speakers. I've got the wires soldered. Place them in these parts, each one of them. Put the piece of fabric in front of the speaker, and then from the inside of the case, insert the speaker gently, and then start to apply some pressure until everything is locked in place. And we're going to do the same thing for the other side. You'll get a feeling for it when you do this yourself. It's a very simple but efficient way to mount the speakers. Next, we'll start mounting the buttons. I've already soldered the wires, and one of these wires on each of these buttons is going to be the common ground. After you inserted all the buttons, you can trim these common wires, and then we'll connect them to a single wire which is going to go to the ground plane of the whole system. We're going to do the same thing for the volume potentiometer. I've shortened the shaft a little bit, and you can see that this custom cap I made for it, it fits perfectly. I'm also going to insert the temperature sensor. This one is going to be visible from the front side. The second sensor is going to be connected on the back side of the case. And also on the back side we have a 3-pin header for the UART communication. and the power supply connector. So once you've soldered all these wires on the board, and by the way, each one of them is marked on the PCB, the next step will be to place the board and the LCD inside the case. So to do this, we're going to insert the LCD, and we're going to use four screws. These are M3 oval head 50mm long metal screws, and to hold everything in place, we're going to use four M3 nuts. You can use whatever tools you may have, pliers, fine pliers would do. Just don't put too much pressure on these screws, because it's really not necessary. And then we're going to gently place the whole thing inside the case. Another thing you can do now is to trim these wires. If they're too long, you can then resolder them. Just don't cut them too short, in case you'll have to reopen and disassemble everything. I've also soldered the antenna, which is a simple insulated wire, and its length is not very critical, and it can be calculated with this formula: L equals lambda divided by 4 equals C divided by 4 times F. This C here is called the velocity factor, and it's basically the speed of light, 299.792.458 meters per second. This lambda here is the wavelength, and our frequency, we're going to take 100 megahertz to simplify this operation here. So our length should be 3 divided by 4, which equals 75 centimeters. So now we're ready to put the back cover on, but before I do this, we're going to place all these three connectors. And I use a very small amount of glue to secure them in place. This connector here for the external temperature sensor has a mounting nut, so we don't need to use any glue for it. And lastly, I'm pulling the antenna through this small hole very gently. And now we can use four screws to secure the back side of the case in its place. It's always a good idea to place small labels here on the back side, especially for this UART header, because you will probably forget which one of these pins is the RX, TX, or the ground pin. The last step, you only have to place the cap for the snooze button. These holes on each corner will act like a guidance for the snooze button, and I'm gluing these two parts together. And now we're just gonna go ahead and use a marker to highlight this 3D printed text. It gives everything a nice touch. I really like this case. After all this time, it's been quite a few years since I've modeled this, and I still like it. It's very simple, but somehow it gives me a warm feeling just by looking at it. And That's what it's all about, you know. If you like something, just go for it. And if you design something and it passes the test of time, you know, you still like the product, you enjoy using it even after a few years, that's how you'll know you've made the right choices. And of course, you may go ahead and improve this design or completely redesign this case. In fact, I encourage you to do so. As long as it remains open source, feel free to do so. And keep me posted if you built this or improved it, and I'd be glad to hear from you. Feedback is very much appreciated.